Are you starting?
Hi everyone, we play Five Nights again. Yeah.
Let's
win. Huh? Let's win. And I'm getting Kyrie.
That's fine.
I don't like that better.
Oh,
yeah, it's taking
too long.
Good evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore alongside Teddy Atlas, and welcome to the MG.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Round one of 12. Good looking right hand after he got hit.
Huh? Guys, you like my green hair, guys?
So we are underway here, and as we've talked about it going into this fight, and you really touched on this, Teddy, the biggest edge comes with him in terms of his speed advantage.
Yeah, not just with his hands, though. Downstairs with his feet, too.
He likes to play around, right?
Huh?
Yeah, be careful with this guy, man.
Why?
He likes to play around.
Not able to land the headshot.
I see.
You're doing that.
And a well-targeted combination by Prince. That is a big right hand
you
after eating one himself.
I'm about to show.
Off to the side, a little swing and a miss going upstairs.
I'm about to show.
Targeting each other, the exchange was something special.
About to show.
I'm
about to show.
What a show.
And he play around.
Here we go. Round two is underway.
No, he's going sometimes. You want this?
He got hit. Oh, now the uppercut. Able to land the hook to the head. Prince is the target of the hook. That worked out really well. Throwing off the right hand after getting tagged like that.
Yeah, that's what I like to see, and that's what the judges are supposed to be looking for. You know, not just being overtaken by a guy just going out there like a Mad Hatter and just throwing punches, but placing the punches, strategically putting them in the right spots. Good job.
It's easy to run too much, right?
Yeah. No, you're doing that.
Well-targeted two-punch combo by Prince. Through this round, commits to the overhand right, and it serves a ball. And bang, and away he goes. There he goes. He goes down for that headshot.
No. Wait, blood come out.
One, two. He went down from a big shot. Now he's got to have some big guts to move along.
You're going to find out exactly what he's made of.
Good, solid right hand he lands there.
Oh my God, I'm moving.
Prince is in there fouling again. Super three-punch combination by Prince.
Keep doing what you're doing. Keep the chance.
Round number four is underway. A chance for us to look at Teddy's scorecard. And obviously, the round is circled there. You see the knockdown was scored.
And that's how professional boxing is supposed to be. The guy who lands the cleaner, more effective punches, he gets an advantage. He gets an extra score.
Well-placed, well-timed combo up top. Takes one to give one. He comes back with a right hand. solid combination by Prince.
That's blocking me. I hate you, block.
Prince is left now getting into the mix.
Ah.
10 seconds to go in this round.
Still bad, still bad, still
bad. Here with that two-punch combination.
Help yourself.
Huh?
Still win this one.
No much.
Back to live action now in what has been a closely contested fight.
Let's keep punching this.
That somebody is still waiting to break through and be a different
move to what?
Effective work with that flush overhand right.
Yes, yes, yes. He's moving.
He is not in good shape.
No, no, no.
Beyond the deck in moments.
Don't punch you. No.
He returns the favor with a right hand of his own.
Stop. You want this?
Combo lands upstairs. Well, I don't know if he's hip to the idea of becoming a counterpuncher, but I get the sense you'd agree with it.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's got the perfect platform, the perfect form for it. The guy's walking in right now, not moving his head much. He can time him, he can counter him.
I'm bleeding.
You are?
Huh?
And round five comes to an end. Well, we've seen this before. A fighter with
now
a bad
I'm having a black eye already.
Sometimes a fighter that now has
no,
a much
you're
greater
that.
Sense of urgency.
Yeah, right now, if he was gambling, if he was in a casino, he's rolling the dice. He's hoping to come up with seven.
We start a new round here. It's hard to believe that we're even in this round based on how that last round finished.
Well, if you ever watch some of those Houdini movies, you know, the great escape artist, kind of hard to believe he got out of some of those fixes he was in. You know, inside that box with chains around the water.
Because you're doing that.
A Houdini right here.
Lands flush with the combination upstairs. Right hand over the top, very accurate with it. He got hit right there, but he also gave one. Solid effort by Raging Bull. He's committed to the combination punching now. It's working out well up top.
Look.
Oh, a big shot comes home for him. And once again, he goes down. The question is, can he rise up again?
No. Okay, you're gonna fight. You're gonna fight, you big baby. Yeah, I'm gonna kill you, baby. I wanna kill you, baby. Huh?
So we've come to the halfway point of what has been a
what?
Very highly competitive bout. And Teddy, if it stays that way throughout this night, then this is gonna be an all-time classic.
So much less. Final round.
I don't know that there's any hope here if we start this new round. He's been knocked down numerous times already tonight, including the last one.
And I'm sure the fateful night with Corrales and Castillo, when Corrales had already been on the floor two times, his mouthpiece was out, it looked like it was over. I'm sure nobody thought that it was only beginning. And it was. Corrales came back and scored a knockout.
Come on, you keep moving too much.
A great combination there.
Huh?
Return to sender. He gives him back one of his own.
Come on, do some moving. You're doing that.
He just missed that shot up top. He is damaged badly there. He may hit the
big. Why do you do that?
Up off the deck.
Come on, that's not funny.
He scores a knockdown.
I'm gonna cut the
case.
And he turned it around because when his opponent scored the knockdown, he got a little careless, a little lazy.
One, two, three, four.
You're cheater.
Hard to prepare for a situation like this, but many do. He's been down, now he's got to survive.
So that's really wrong. It's not hard to prepare. It's a must.
I want to flop.
If you're a trainer, that's what you do. You teach a guy. If you're in this situation, this is what you do. You grab on, you move your head, you survive.
Yeah. No.
He's going to come forward this time.
Start around number 8 here, and I can just tell I'm looking at the body language
right
now, and I see Prince has got a lot left.
You have a lot of
scorecards, but I like the way he looks right now.
Yeah, I do too. And when you just talk about the body language, the mental part is so important. We always talk about
the people looking at him. I'm looking at my health. I'm moving a lot there.
Here in these
I'm
later rounds, you can start to see a trend, and one is developing. He cannot get away from that left hand.
Now listen, when you throw your punches, it's not enough just to chuck them out there. You gotta throw.
Prince is gonna have a point deduction here. The repeated low blows finally caught up with him.
See, you a cheater.
You gotta love the offense there, putting his punches.
I'm looking at my health.
That's just good, solid, accurate work by Prince.
No.
Committing now to the left hand. Good straight shot. That's great stuff. He fires one right back after taking one. Got a
little like
work by Raging Bull.
Really a black guy.
Back underway here in live fight action. Tough fight to score. Very, very
even.
Can I see
some moving before I quit? Why are you moving like that?
Because he wants you to get close.
Prince's left landing well. Nice strike after catching one by Raging Bull. Good combination.
He's moving a lot.
Oh, that's good stuff. Fire him right back.
No. I'm looking my help.
Throwing a lot of punches here. Now his opponent is showing.
Stop!
Oh, he is stuck. He could go down. Nice work doubling
no.
up that jab.
Before I punch your face.
Nice work with the overhand right. And that's the end of round 9. Let me paint this picture for you. You got to figure out a strategy, and your fighter's down to one eye.
I hate that.
I hope that he got some history for
you.
Boy, watch the movie.
You're doing that.
300. You saw that movie. Oh, yeah. Great movie about the Spartans where they were outnumbered, and they had to get the terrain right to fight the fight. They had to get into the mountains where the greater forces, the great army, could not be the great army. They could not get in there and battle where they could take advantage of their superior forces. That's what he's got to do. He's got to fight into a part, a portion of the ring where he will
so, mommy,
be vulnerable on that side.
You lean? Lean to it.
Back to action here at the start of this round, which is just part of what has been a very evenly fought fight. One of those fights that's going to be very hard to score. Now he's putting his punches together, the combination upstairs. Able to land with the right. Oh, he just misses with that headshot.
Stop moving. He moved too much.
Pooping. Takes one, but gets one. Good work by Raging Bull.
Yeah, call me Raging Bull.
Going upstairs. Prince's timing with his head movement has been ideal. We have not seen his opponent being able to land anything clean up top tonight.
No, because his opponent is not making the proper adjustments. You know, when the head is moving, the body's still there. You can't catch the head. Go downstairs to the body. You paralyze that head. You start to take that movement away. Before you know it, the guy's not quite as elusive.
And that's
the
end of
round
10.
Throw punches. Don't walk into the
round
throwing a punch. Go, time.
You're bleeding or what?
I'm sure as a trainer, when you get in a spot like this, there's extra emphasis of letting your charge know just what he's capable of pulling off. I look at your scorecard, He's only trailing by a very small margin here in round number 11.
Well, the key right now as a trainer, and you just touched on it, you have to remind your char, your fighter, things that he understood when it was nice and calm, when everything was very understandable, when he told you in the gym, hey, I want to be champion. You got to remind him of that and say, okay, here's your chance. Here's your moment.
He fires off the combination there and it lands. Prince is impressing the judges and himself with that right hand. Oh, you see him with the left of the head there? Good fundamental work in the 1-2 there.
Oh my God.
Accurate with the overhand.
Now
right.
Is he playing around?
And that's the end of round 11.
Yeah.
One of his eyes is completely
now I'm gonna lose because I have a
they
black guy.
They want to give themselves every chance they have
there's
to win it. What do they need to do?
Well, I'm not being a black guy. I'm not being a black guy.
Corner, get pressure on that cut. Get the right medicines in there. And maybe find a way to
kind of
trying
to work,
dump some water below the corner where the referee has to spend a little bit more time cleaning it up. They want to get a little bit more seconds.
He throws a big
my God, let me retire.
Well, like
stop
you
moving.
Then
my brother's playing because he's cheating. And he tell me he's trying to let me win and he's
right
and he not. You're a cheater.
He tried to nab him up top but was unable to connect. Able to place the right hand in there. Nice combination. Throwing more than one. Both scored there.
Oh my God.
Able to time that left hand and score with it.
This is the final round
of
the night.
Right up until that final bell moments ago. Both
I
want to
win.
Tried to determine their fate. But now it's in the hands of these judges.
The pressure now is truly on the judges because this is the kind of fight where you need talent as a judge, you need
what?
Discipline as a judge, and of course, honestly,
I was having
to
I win.
Right decision
here. He did better.
Listen, he was the better fighter, he was the busier fighter, he's the fighter that absolutely deserves to have that unanimous decision go the way it did.
Remember,
you
didn't
like
thumbs up to subscribe to my channel,
bye.